Hello everyone, welcome back to another video, and in this video we will be looking at what is different between web 2.0 and web 3.0. So for them who are new to these words, let me explain you that web 2.0 means the normal internet that we are using nowadays, and web 3.0 is basically a concept that was derived from Bitcoin. So without wasting time, let's start and let's jump into the difference between the two and look at the working of basically web 2.0 and web 3.0. So let me open the Canva, and here we will be looking at that how web 2.0 is different from web 3.0, basically how 2.0 works, and then we will be compare its working with 3.0, which is also known as D web, and D stands for basically decentralized web. So this D actually means decentralized. So let's start our video and let's see that how web 2.0 works. So basically, whenever you go to your browser, and that can be from phone, that can be from laptop, that can be for computer, you click on a URL or you enter a URL, or basically you search with the domain name which is inside that URL. So what does the browser do? Browser basically, suppose this is your browser, which is also referred to as client in web 2.0, and this client basically makes a request, and this request is made by that URL which you have clicked or entered, and this URL, basically this request, goes to the DNS, and DNS is just the domain name system. It actually converts your URL to the IP address of the server where that URL points. So it will take your URL and it will see, okay, let me see where it points. So it will point to that server which your URL might be pointing. Suppose you entered facebook.com, and then that Facebook has some IP address of 176 point something something something. So basically that Facebook server will be receiving that request, and this server not only have received the request, and but it actually try to understand that what you are trying to have with that request. Suppose you want to have your login page, or you want to have your profile page. So basically the Facebook server will be checking, okay, what this request actually means, and that is basically the backend coding. So whenever the Facebook gets, okay, you want this, he will search that is there this thing needs to be provided from the database, or it will be authenticating you that, okay, are you the person who is actually authenticated to use those resources that which you are demanding. So after it takes your request, it will search the database and give you the proper response according to your request and authentication. So this was the concept in web 2.0. but the main thing is here is that everything is controlled centrally. That means the things are centralized, your system is centralized. Whenever the Facebook will be failing, the servers of Facebook will be failing, the entire system can't respond. There will be no another backup. Okay, they have backup, but then to load that backup really takes time, and if someone have to alter anything, it just have to come to this Facebook server and he can make the changes according to his will. So this was all about web 2.0. but then there comes a point when now we want our security, the security of data. We want freedom. We don't want anyone to take down our content, which we have seen in YouTube many times, like that Carrie Minati case. So we have seen that, okay, I get that in web 2.0 these problems are there. So how web 3.0 is solving these problems? So basically in web 3.0, it makes everything decentralized. So we have seen that here we have DNS, it is also a centralized system, and that's why only a few months back we have seen a huge downtime in websites like Google, Facebook, Amazon. So there is a problem of single point failing in web 2.0, and to solve this problem, the web 3.0 provide us a decentralized system, and this decentralized system basically stores every piece of information to every node which is connected to that blockchain. So this means that suppose here is your browser, and you need a dweb or you need a web 3.js support to actually access decentralized webs, which is blockchain, which is based on basically blockchain. So to have that, you need MetaMask in your browser inbuilt, or you need a decentralized web browser, so like Brave. So basically it connects, the browser connects to a wallet, and in general cases right now we are using MetaMask as the wallet for our Google Chrome browser. So this MetaMask, what it does, whenever you make a request, it provides some token, and then this request is made to a decentralized DNS, and this decentralized DNS will transfer the request to a file storage, and this will be also decentralized. So here everything is basically decentralized. That means the informations are not stored at just one place. So basically this will be also a blockchain, and this will be also a blockchain, and these blockchains will be having their own tokens. So this Meetup Max, this wallet, this is basically a wallet. So this wallet actually helps you to pay the fees to access the information. Basically, to access information, you don't have to pay fees, but to make changes, you actually have to pay fees, because then you have to make a transaction over here. So we will be seeing this in another video. Today, we will be just seeing the working of Web 3.0 or DWebs. So basically, whenever you make a request, it makes the request to decentralized DNS. And this will make a request to the blockchain of that file storage. And then from here, you will be getting requests to the blockchain where actual your smart contracts will be written. So these smart contracts are nothing. They are just a piece of code. And you can also term this as program. So this program basically tells that, okay, how this request needs to be handled. The same way our backend code used to tell us in this Web 2.0. So after getting all the information, it will send back the data or the response to the person who actually called the request. So this was all about Web 3.0, and we will be seeing a complete whole detailed video in some another video. Right now, it was just a thing, just a small comparison between Web 2.0 and Web 3.0. So thank you guys for watching this video.